Do you know what determines lung volume? The straightforward answer is the balance between elastic recoil of lungs and recoil of chest wall. Don't worry, we will break down every detail. To understand this balance, we will first understand properties of lung and chest wall separately. Then we will see how they both interact. Let's get started. First, the properties of lungs. Lungs contain elastic fibers. When the lungs are expanded by external force, these fibers get stretched. When the force is released, they passively recoil back to their resting state. As they recoil, the lungs collapse. In short, when lungs are stretched, they have tendency to collapse due to this elastic recoil. When no force is being applied, lung volume is about 10% of total lung capacity. That was simple. Now let's see properties of chest wall. At resting position, chest volume is about 60% of total lung capacity. Inspiratory muscles can expand the chest. When expanded, chest wall has tendency to recoil inward. So when this expanding force is released, it moves inwards to its resting position. Expiratory muscles, on the other hand, reduces chest wall volume. And again, when the force is released, chest wall moves outward. That was the detail of chest wall. Now let's bring lungs and chest wall together. So far we studied them separately to get the fundamentals clear. In body, however, lungs and chest wall move together as a single unit. Under resting condition of this single unit, lungs want to be at 10% of total lung capacity. So they pull chest wall inward. And chest wall wants to be at 60%. So it pulls lungs outward. The equilibrium is achieved at about 40% of total lung capacity. At this equilibrium, lungs are constantly trying to collapse back to 10%. And chest wall tries to go back to 60%. However, they are prevented from doing so by pleura. It keeps the lungs and chest wall glued together. Because of this, lung and chest wall move together as a single unit. This is the actual final situation that we have in normal healthy body. In some diseases of pleura, lungs and chest wall do not work as a single unit, leading to problems in respiration. But that's a topic for a separate video. For now, let's come back to lung volumes. We saw that under resting condition, equilibrium is achieved at 40% of total lung capacity. That exactly is functional residual capacity, the volume of lung after quiet restful expiration. With maximum efforts by inspiratory muscles, the volume can be increased to 100% of total lung capacity. And with maximum efforts of expiratory muscles, it can be reduced to residual volume. I hope you now have clear understanding of what determines lung volumes. If you struggle understanding medical concepts, subscribe to the channel and also follow me at other social media. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.